Done. Ready.
Yeah. Get him in. Woo! Do you see any dolphins? Over.
Whoa, there's a few manta rays down there. Come on in. Let's check them out.
On this episode of Crash Creatures, we'll be diving into the world of dolphins, considered by many to be one of our most intelligent mammal relatives. We'll explore their underwater world and learn what makes these creatures so unique and why humans have been fascinated by them. But we're gonna have fun playing with them too, right? Absolutely. How can't you have fun diving with dolphins? Water surrounding the islands.
Hey, Chris, I see some.
Dolphins? Where? Let me see.
Hey, come back! Where are they going? Hey, over here!
Hey, what's going on? The dolphins have taken off. That's weird. Dolphins have been known to save swimmers. I mean, everyone knows that. They're one of the smartest creatures around.
And around the world, there are great examples of creature intelligence. Like elephants, who are believed to have incredible memories. And chimps, who are great tool users. Or how about another primate? Gorillas, who can be trained to use sign language. Scarlet macaws, who can mimic animal and human voices. Or how about wolves, who are able to plan and coordinate the takedown of much bigger animals. And then, there's sea lions, who can be trained to understand simple sentences. And we're about to find out why humans consider dolphins to be one of the smartest creatures around. Our problem is finding them.
Do you see them? I don't see anything but water. I wonder where that pod of dolphins could have gone.
Hey, if you're looking for dolphins, go a little batty.
We've already covered bats, Tark. What do they have to do with... That's right. Believe it or not, bats and dolphins have something amazing in common. It's called echolocation. Echolocation sounds like a tough word, but it's actually easy to understand. As a bat flies, it fires out ultrasonic shrieks from its mouth. Their large and sensitive ears pick up these ultrasonic shrieks as they bounce off objects like trees, cave walls, or their favorite meal. This means that they can navigate in the dark without bumping into trees and zero in on any bugs that happen to be within their sonic sights. That's echolocation. And believe it or not, dolphins use echolocation just like bats do. Guys, what we need here is a little echolocation, or in the case of humans, sonar.
Sonar is the closest thing that humans have to the natural echolocation of dolphins. With the sonar device, we can send a sound wave down through the water. When it hits something, it bounces back up, and we get an image on the screen. Something's down there. Let's check it out.
You got your underwater communicator?
Underwater communicator? Check.
All right, let's go.
Hey, Chris, I think I see something down there. Look, dolphins?
No, we found something else. Stingrays!
Totally cool. Stingrays. They may not be so easy to find, but they're one of the most amazing swimmers in the world.
Hey, Chris, did you know that stingrays have been called pancake sharks? That makes sense. They do sort of look like steamrolled sharks. But stingrays are no joke. Their flattened-out shape, their wing-like pectoral fins, and their boneless bodies really let them glide through the water. Stingrays spend a lot of time camouflaged on the seabed, but when something disturbs them, or when they're on the hunt, they can really fly. The most amazing thing about scuba diving is that you feel like you're entering another world. And you are! There's just as much diversity of life underwater as there is on land, maybe even more.
Unusual to us, like this rock lobster, but then we must look pretty unusual to them.
I wonder what a sea cucumber thinks of us. To most humans, it looks like a vegetable, but it's actually an animal.
Whoa, look at the saltzer fish. He only comes out at night and needs those big eyes to see in low light. Hey, and there's a puffer fish. When this guy's threatened, he blows himself up to look twice as big. Hey, how about moray eels? They usually eat small prey like crabs. Yeah, but don't be fooled. They've been known to bite divers, so let's keep our distance.
Hey, Martin, come here, take a look. The stingray's taken off. Something must have disturbed him. Hey, look, it's a remora! And you know what that means. Right, I think we may have company. Sharks!
Sharks? You guys gotta be careful.
Don't worry, Al, we're okay. These are Caribbean reef sharks, and they are dangerous. But if we play it cool, we'll have no worries. These sharks eat squid and bony fishes, which means they're not going to be a big threat to us, unless we provoke them. You know, hanging with sharks is cool. It's crazy that sharks have such a bad rep. I mean, lots of people think sharks are like underwater merchants of death. It's true that sharks are incredibly fast and they're great hunters, but that's just one side of the story. There are a lot of sharks that aren't dangerous to humans at all. Here's a perfect example, Al. The nurse shark. They're bottom feeders, eating lobsters, sea urchins, and crabs.
Hey, I never knew all this about sharks.
See? A quick trip to Bimini, rent some scuba gear, and you learn something new every day.
Yeah, but we still have to find those dolphins.
Don't worry, Al. We're still on the search.
Martin! In the distance, I see something there.
Look.
What's the sound?
We don't hear anything, but we do see something.
I don't see anything. Don't tell me there's something wrong with this thing again. We found them! Dolphins!
That was the sound you heard. We hear it too. That clicking sound. Is dolphins communicating. And it's not just clicks. Dolphins sound off in all sorts of ways. Squawks, whistles, quacks, barks. Dolphins are great communicators. And when bottlenose dolphins are sick or in pain, they'll let out a distress whistle. Within seconds, other dolphins will come to the rescue, lifting them to the surface so we can breathe. Dolphins are amazing.
But it's not just communication that makes them amazing. I had no idea dolphins were such great jumpers. Was I thinking of porpoises? Accessing information on dolphins and porpoises. So there's a dolphin. But what about porpoises? What is the difference between a dolphin and a porpoise?
If you want to tell the difference between a dolphin and a porpoise, just look at their bodies and their teeth.
Porpoises are smaller, with rounder bodies, smaller snout, and spade-shaped teeth.
So how do dolphins move so quickly through the water? Well, first off, they have sleek, streamlined bodies, narrowing out in the front and back, like a submarine. And don't forget their tails. It's their propeller. When dolphins lift their tails, water moves over their head and back, pushing their bodies forward and down. Plus, their smooth, rubbery skin gets greased by a layer of oily skin cells that sheds as they swim. That oil lets them slide through the water.
Oil reduces friction. So if I cover myself with baby oil, I'll be able to swim much faster. I'll time you.
Okay.
Oil really does work. Dolphins aren't fish. They're mammals like us, so they have to come up to the surface every few minutes to breathe.
Dolphins leap out of the water when they really want to move fast.
That's because it's easier to move through the air than it is through the water. Ready?
Ready.
There's another way dolphins communicate, using their bodies. One of the ways they do that is by nuzzling, rubbing, and patting. It's the dolphin version of a caress. Dolphins will often hang out with divers. They seem to crave human company. Dolphins also use their blowholes to communicate. A blast of bubbles might mean they're curious or confused. If they're frustrated or angry, they'll come to the surface to give a good blast.
Communication. Now that's a great example of how smart dolphins are. They can talk to each other.
But whistling, clicking, and blowhole blasting aren't the only ways underwater creatures communicate. Another way is staring us right in the face. Color! This spectacular show of color may not mean a lot to us, but every color, every stripe, and every pattern communicates something. Colors and patterns are like badges, telling other fish their rank, identity, and gender. Some fish can even change color when they change moods. This coral shrimp eats the parasites off other fish. Its bright stripes are like an advertisement. Come here and get clean! That's why he's sometimes called the barber pole shrimp. And here's another cool form of communication. These lobsters keep in touch by using vibrations when danger is near. Like a shark, the lobster that spots it creates a warning vibration that can carry as far as 55 yards. It tells other lobsters in the area, "Incoming shark! Head for the rocks, dude!"
Wow, that's a pretty smart underwater creature. So dolphins aren't the only ones who can communicate.
Yeah, but communication isn't necessarily a sign of intelligence. But one thing that is a sign of intelligence, and is also something dolphins love to do, is play!
Something few people realize is that a lot of animals play. It's a way for them to stimulate their minds and have fun. And are they having fun? Wait a minute. No, they're not. They're in trouble.
Hey, Martin, where are you?
Chris, I'm over here. I'm caught in something. Help!
Chris, you better get to him quickly. His tank's really low. Martin's Dolphin's only got 58 seconds before he'll run out of air.
Oh, no! I'm on my way, Martin. Don't worry. Hurry up, will ya? I just said I've got 58 seconds.
Well, actually, you're down to 40 seconds.
Where is he? Hey, Chris! Anytime you're ready!
Seconds.
Ready when you are, Chris. I think I saw him over here.
15 seconds.
I guess I better get you to the surface. Yeah, that would be a good idea.
2 seconds.
For dolphins. Dolphins usually come to the surface for air every 3 minutes, and they can stay under for a maximum of 8 minutes. But if they're caught in a net, they can't get to the surface to breathe, and they drown.
And why do dolphins get caught in nets? The answer is tuna. Some species of dolphin and tuna swim near each other, and that's why a lot of dolphins were caught and killed in the fishing nets. If you can believe it, in 1 year, 100,000 dolphins were killed this way. What do you think it's like for dolphins trying to get out of one of those nets? Well, take a piece of string and wrap it around your hand like this. And then without using your mouth or your other hand, try and get it off. It's impossible.
But it's not just tuna fishing that's hurting dolphins. Another huge problem is pollution.
When dolphins absorb polluted food and water into their bodies, it's only a matter of time before the toxic chemicals will get to them.
Then they don't have a chance.
And it's not just dolphins. Environmental pollution affects all sea creatures.
Plastic bags are really bad for sea turtles because the sea turtles eat the bags thinking they're jellyfish, they get sick, and they die. And monofilament fishing line is bad for about any animal because it never biodegrades and it can get tangled up in their feet, flippers. It's a real mess. These six-pack rings can get caught around a bird's neck or in a fish's gill, and once they're on, they're impossible to get off. And the animal usually dies.
You know, if a few people take a little time to clean up a beach or two, it'll help dolphins and all sea creatures survive. Boy, dolphins get hit on every side.
Maybe they should head back to the land.
Back to the land? What are you talking about?
Dolphins and whales are related to cows.
Dolphins and whales are related to cows?
And bison and buffalo. Millions of years ago, cow-like creatures started hanging out in water, eating away just like hippos do. Eventually, they fully adapted to life underwater and became...
dolphins!
Woo-hoo!
Bottlenose dolphins. They're spotted dolphins.
Pod of wild spotted dolphins. That's really neat.
Come on, swim.
Hurry up. We don't want to lose them like last time.
Oh, man, these boots, I can never get them on.
We're flippers. Yup.
Man, one thing I know, dolphins never have to go through this.
And they want to pull!
Spotted
dolphins aren't much different from the bottlenose, except for one obvious difference. Their spots. They're actually born spotless and develop them with age. Those spots help them blend in with light patterns, making them hard for predators to spot. One of the reasons dolphins live in pods is so they can help each other out. They've been known to help a sick pod member for weeks, pushing them up to the surface when they need air. And living in a pod offers great protection from predators. A tight cluster of dolphins makes it almost impossible for killer whales or sharks to pick one off. And it means they can cool their senses and find more food than they would alone.
Hey, look, I found a mom and baby dolphin. Fin rubbing is the dolphin way of showing affection. This baby's sure sticking close to mom. That way, she can get pulled along by her draft, saving her a lot of energy, which a baby dolphin needs.
Dolphin calves will hang with mom for about 6 years. That's a long time in the creature world. But they need that time to learn the traditions of the pod, and there's a lot to learn.
Look! A dolphin tail slap! Man, they're constantly in contact. Every nudge, every touch, every tail slap means something. It means there's always a buddy to play with.
Some people think living in groups is a sign of intelligence, but I know what you're gonna say, Tark.
Lots of creatures hang out in groups. It's easier to take care of the young, and it's way easier to get food when you're working together. It's a natural part of creature life. I'll never understand why humans are so obsessed with intelligence.
It's not creature intelligence humans are fascinated with so much as the amazing and seemingly clever things they do. Scientists believe that when dolphins snooze, they only shut down half of their brain. The other half is awake, controlling stuff like surfacing for air. Talk about sleeping with one eye open.
And when they're sleeping, dolphins drift slowly along the surface, alongside a few dolphins that are awake. These guards keep an eye out for danger, like
a tiger shark!
And when it comes to detecting things like food or predators, that's where echolocation comes in.
When dolphins use echolocation, they don't just send out one sound, they send out hundreds of sounds per second. The more sounds they send out, the better the picture they get back.
And to get a picture of how accurate echolocation is, check this out. This guy's zeroing in on something under the sand. It could be a flounder or a razorfish. Hard to believe, but if you dig under the sand, you can find a treasure trove of stuff to eat. Hey, look, that goldfish is digging too. This pod is really scanning the bottom for food. They're only stopping to come up for air. And then it's back to work. Echolocation provides sound images so detailed that trained dolphins can tell the difference between a nickel and a dime, even when they're buried in mud.
what are those dolphins doing? They're finished eating. I don't think they're playing. Hey guys, are those dolphins fighting?
These dolphins aren't fighting at all. They're courting. Dolphins who like each other will try to get the other one's attention. They'll circle, corkscrew their bodies, and swim upside down. You know, it's no surprise that humans are so fascinated with dolphins.
When you add it all up, social setup, communication, protecting the pod, you're talking about one amazing creature.
You know, guys, I couldn't agree with you more. Dolphins are amazing. Intelligence, language, curiosity, playfulness. Dolphins and people are a lot alike. No wonder Chris and Martin fit in so well. Really are intelligent creatures. They're one of my favorites. But Tark's right too. Intelligence isn't everything. For some creatures, other things are more important. And here's the greatest thing of all. When two different creatures can meet and actually have fun hanging out together. These guys may never come topside again.
The underwater world of the dolphin is something you never want to stop exploring. Hey, and let's hope it's a world we'll be able to keep exploring for a long, long time.